Along the rivers of America in Frontierland, you'll find the Disneyland Petrified Tree, jokingly referred to as the oldest attraction in the park. As a geologist, I love the Disneyland Petrified Tree, but I'm also so frustrated because visitors to Disneyland never get to learn any of the actual history of the Petrified Tree, as its plaque has outdated, incorrect information that has not been updated or corrected since it was installed in the park in the late 1950s. The Petrified Tree was originally gifted to Disneyland by Lillian Disney in 1957, but based on records, Walt purchased the tree specifically for Disneyland in 1956, although stories persisted that it was bought as an anniversary present for Lillian, who then graciously gifted it to Disneyland. The original plaque for the tree indicated that the Petrified Tree came from the Pike Petrified Forest in Colorado, and that 55 to 70 million years ago, this huge petrified tree was part of a subtropical forest in what is now Colorado, say by scientists to have been of the redwood or sequoia species. During some prehistoric era, a cataclysmic upheaval caused silica-laden water to overspread the living forest. Wood cells were changed over the course of time to sandstone, opals were formed within the tree trunk itself. Looking at the metal plaque currently found at the tree today, you can see that only the formatting and wording has been slightly changed. All of the actual information itself has been unchanged since 1957. I want to emphasize just how long ago 1957 is in terms of our geologic knowledge. Plate tectonics, the fundamental mechanics of how Earth's crust is formed and recycled, wasn't even discovered until the mid-1960s. When Walt bought the Petrified Tree in Colorado in 1956, it came from the then privately owned Pike Petrified Forest. However, Congress established the forest as a national monument in the late 1960s, known as the Florissant Fossil Beds National Monument. And as a national monument operated by the National Park Service, there is a lot of really great accessible information about the many petrified trees and other fossils found there. Well, in 1957, scientists' best guess was that the tree was between 55 to 70 million years old. We've known for many decades that the trees from the Florissant fossil beds, including the Disneyland Petrified Tree, are 34 million years old. The rocks of the Florissant formation have been well dated through radiometric dating of volcanic material, and the petrified tree stumps actually have a really interesting volcanic history. In 1957, the best geologic explanation for the petrified tree's formation was that there was a cataclysmic upheaval of silica-laden water that overspread the living forest, which isn't much of an explanation since there's no indication of what this cataclysm was. The actual explanation is far more specific and interesting. 34 million years ago, when Colorado had warm temperate and subtropical plants, nearby explosive volcanoes spewed out loose ash and debris. When rainfall mixes with loose volcanic material, it can create extremely fast-moving and deadly mud flows called lahars. A lahar was triggered and rapidly traveled from the flanks of the volcano toward the forest valley. The tree trunks became trapped in muddy, ashy material, which cut them off from oxygen, stopping decay and decomposition. The trees became petrified when dissolved silica from volcanic ash was carried into the trees through groundwater, forming quartz and opal within the tree cells. So the Disneyland Petrified Tree and all of the petrified trees from the Florissant fossil beds are 34 million years old and formed when a lahar encompassed the tree trunks in muddy debris. Only the tree trunks became petrified as the tops of the trees were exposed to oxygen and eventually fell off and decayed. I thus think it is long overdue to update the information on the plaque for the Disneyland Petrified Tree, especially when there is so much great, accurate information on the tree's many siblings from the National Park Service. So next time you're at Disneyland, stop and take a minute to appreciate and enjoy the Disneyland Petrified Tree, a piece of real geologic history which hopefully one day will have a plaque with updated, correct information. But thanks for watching!